As a project manager, we need to learn, acquire, and develop some skills and techniques to ensure project's success. There are many techniques required in a project. There are most common or used techniques, and one of these is data representation techniques. There are 15 identified data representation techniques we need to know to manage our project better. Affinity Diagram. Cause and Effect Diagram. Control Charts. Flow Charts. Hierarchical Charts. Histogram. Logical Data Model. Matrix Diagram. Matrix-based Chart. Mind Mapping. Probability and Impact Matrix. Scatter Diagram. Stakeholder Engagement Assessment Matrix. Stakeholder Mapping. Text-oriented Format. Affinity Diagram. Affinity diagrams are used to group data gathered during research or ideas generated during brainstorming sessions. Organize an unsorted or unorganized list of data to add structure. Stimulate new patterns of thinking sparked by groups formed during the affinity method process. Cause and effect diagram. Cause and effect diagrams are also known as fishbone diagrams, YY diagrams, or Ishikawa diagrams. This type of diagram breaks down the causes of the problem statement identified into discrete branches, helping to identify the main or root cause of the problem. Control charts. A control chart is a graphical display of data over time and against established control limits that has a center line that assists in detecting a trend of plotted values toward either control limits. To explain it in a simple way, control charts are a way of visualizing how processes are doing over time. Flow charts. A flowchart displays graphically the project's objective and seeks to more logically order the activities therein. But, a flowchart can also help with monitoring progress and even status reporting. The project management flowchart is one of the many tools you need as a project manager to control the project. Hierarchical charts. Organizational charts, or hierarchy charts, are the graphical representation of an organization's structure. Its purpose is to illustrate the reporting relationships and chains of command within the organization. Histogram. The PMP histogram provides information about a process in terms of time and the occurrence of specific aspects. Instead of an overwhelming list of numbers, the histogram conveys critical information with an image. Logical data model. A logical data model, LDM, is a complete representation of data requirements and the structural business rules that govern data quality in support of projects' requirements. Matrix diagram. A matrix diagram is defined as a new management planning tool used for analyzing and displaying the relationship between data sets. The matrix diagram shows the relationship between two, three, or four groups of information. L-shaped, two groups. C-shaped, three groups. X-shaped, four groups. Matrix-based chart. A RAM is a matrix-based chart that is used to illustrate the connections between the work that needs to be done and project team members. A RAM can be developed at varying levels of detail, commonly at the activity or deliverable level. Typically, the list of deliverables or activities are on the left-hand column with the team member names across the top. Each deliverable or activity will be assigned to the appropriate individuals. This will aid in communication amongst the team members and help expose any gaps that may exist. Mind mapping. Idea or mind mapping is not a new technique in project management. It is a technique that is used to collect and consolidate ideas created through brainstorming sessions with the team members. The consolidated map reflects the common ground as well as differences in understanding or generating new ideas. Probability and impact matrix. Probability and impact matrix uses the combination of probability and impact scores of individual risks and ranks/prioritizes them for easy handling of the risks. In other words, the probability and impact matrix helps to determine which risks need detailed risk response plans. It is vital to understand the priority for each risk as it allows the project team to appreciate the relative importance of each risk. Scatter diagram. It can demonstrate a relationship between any element of a process, environment, or activity on one axis and a quality defect on the other axis. Use the scatter diagram as a standalone tool or in conjunction with other quality tools to ensure decisions are data-driven. Stakeholder Engagement Assessment Matrix. The Stakeholder Engagement Assessment Matrix is a simple yet powerful project management technique to document desired and monitor actual engagement levels of stakeholders. It helps identify potential gaps in the involvement of stakeholders. Stakeholder Mapping. Stakeholder mapping is the visual process of laying out all the stakeholders of a product, project, or idea on one map. The main benefit of a stakeholder map is to get a visual representation of all the people who can influence your project and how they are connected. Text-oriented format. Documents in text format that provide information such as responsibilities, authority, competencies, and qualifications. Great job! Keep moving forward. See you in our next videos.